In this video, we're going to look at modularity, and I'm going to go create a new project, and this will be lesson three. And I'm going to right click and create a new Python file called lesson three. And we've seen that a program can be composed of a sequence of statements. For example, so here's a program, and in Python this would look like so. So let's go ahead and run this and test it. Please enter your name. Hello, Mark. Welcome to Python. So if we look at this body of code, we can ask how many different things is it doing? And it's doing three things. It's getting input, and then it's doing a calculation, and then it's writing output. Now, in a small program like that, it's pretty easy to read and understand, but as the program becomes more and more complicated, it becomes much more difficult to understand and maintain. And in particular, if there's a problem with the code anywhere, trying to track down exactly where that problem occurs can be difficult. You might need to sort through tens of thousands of lines of code to find the one line that had a problem. So instead of just having all of our code in a simple sequence like this, what we're going to do instead is break it into simple modules. And a module in Python looks like this. So I'm going to go ahead and uncomment these. Control slash gets rid of the comments. And then I'm going to tab everything over. And then I'm going to put everything inside of a module. So we'll start with module greet user, and it's not going to take any parameters, which we'll learn about those in a while. And then that's balanced by end module at the end. So here all of the code lives inside of a module, which is a name chunk of code. Now, if we want to find the piece of code that greets the user, we can look through our code for a module named greet user, and the code will be inside. And then the Python for this looks like so. Def is used to define a new module, and we put the name of the module, and then open paren, close paren, just like in the pseudocode, and then colon. And then everything inside the module is indented over one tab. So if I run this code, it's going to define a module named greetUser, but it won't actually run it. In order to run it, I need to call the module, and I do that like so. And now when I call it, it does the same thing as before. Now, as I mentioned before, this module is still doing more than one thing, and so we can make this code more cohesive by splitting it into separate modules. So, for example, let's start with this print statement, and we might want to move this into a separate module that takes greeting as a parameter. So I'm going to go ahead and split the code into two modules. So I'm going to have a module output greeting, and it's going to take an input parameter called greeting, and greeting is of type string. So I say string greeting, like so. And then I'm just going to have this display statement. And then I'm going to end my module. So now, in order to call this module, I need to add a line. And I pass in an argument, which is passed to this module. So the basic idea here is that the value of greeting gets passed in to output greeting and bound to the parameter greeting which this thing is accepting. And then it gets displayed, and when the module exits, it returns, comes back to here, and then the whole thing exits. So I do basically the same thing in Python. I say def output greeting, and in Python I don't have to say what type of each parameter I'm passing in. Python does that for me. And then I move this print message into here. And then once again, the indentation is telling Python that I'm done with all the code in this function. So to call my output greeting module, I just say output greeting, and then pass in greeting, like so. So once again, if I run the code, it should do the same thing. And it does. Now, I can't actually put this line of code into a module just yet, because I can pass name in as a parameter, but I don't have any way of returning the value to greet user. So in order to do that, I need something called a function, and that's talked about in chapter 6.3, or section 3 of chapter 6. And the pseudocode for a function is going to look just like the pseudocode for a module, except that it's going to use the function keyword, and it's also going to return a type. So let's look at that. So for example, I can create a function which returns a string, and then I give it a name, and it takes a parameter, like so. So this is a function named calculateGreeting. It takes a parameter called name, which is of type string, and then it returns a value that's of type string. So here I have my calculation. First I need to declare the string for greeting, and then I set greeting equal to basically this line of code here. Let's get rid of that. And then to return the value, I say return greeting. And then I'm done with my function. So I call the function the same way as I call a module, except that since it returns a value, I can save that value inside of a variable. So for example, greeting is equal to calculate greeting name. So I input name, then I pass name into calculate greeting where it gets bound to name. I declare a string called greeting, and then I set the value of greeting to be this value. Then I return the value. So this whole thing basically gets replaced by the value that's returned here, and that value gets stored inside this variable, which is defined right here. And then that variable, the value is passed into output greeting, where it's displayed. Then this returns, and my whole thing returns. So let's see that in code. And if I want to add the declare, just like I have in my pseudocode, I can say greeting equals that. And then where I call it, instead of setting greeting equal to this string, I can set greeting equal to calculate greeting of name. So it works the same. Now finally, this input right here, that can be a module as well. So I can have, for example, a module called input name that returns the name value. And any module that returns a value is a function. So let's go ahead and do that. And this is going to return a string as well. It's not going to take any parameters. And basically, I'm going to take these two lines of code and put them in here. I need to add a declare statement for name. And then after I've input the name, I can return it and end my function. Then to call it, I set the value of name here, this name, equal to whatever value input name returns. And in Python, like so. So the code is doing the same thing as the original bit of code, and it's significantly longer than it used to be, but then there's an advantage here in that if I want to reuse this input name module somewhere else, it's pretty easy to copy this module and to reuse it. And also, if I have a problem with the part of the code that's, for example, calculating the greeting, well, I know it's going to be inside of this module, so I know where to look to fix it. So even though I end up with slightly longer code, what I get in return is code that's easier to maintain and modify.